Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion Vue Calendar using the Vue CLI command. And how to add the calendar component to an application using the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars package. The Vue Calendar displays the date and days of the week. It provides month, year, and decade views to quickly navigate to the desired date. It supports minimum, maximum, and disabled dates to restrict date selection. I will show you how to configure this control along with a few of its basic features like setting specific date to the calendar, multidate selection, and navigation between different calendar views. Let me show you the application creation process. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue Node and Vue Class component. In the command prompt, I run the command npm install global Vue CLI. Then I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name MyVueProject. I navigate to the desired location and install the Vue Class component library using the command npm install Vue Class component and specify the version. Then install the calendar package using the npm install Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars command. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the calendar component, navigate to the app.vue page and import the calendar component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Calendars package and register this component plugin to the Vue. By doing this, all the component's child directives are also globally registered. Then I add the EJS calendar tag to the template section. Then import the material theme styles into the style section to apply styles to the calendar component. Next, the Syncfusion license key must be registered. Open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the Vue trial license. From 2022 Volume 1 release, license key is mandatory in Vue projects to avoid license warning. Now, I run this project using the command npm run serve. As you can see, the output displays the calendar component with today's date highlighted. You can also navigate between dates, months, and years and vice versa. When I click the Today button, today's date will be selected. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date value so that the calendar highlights the date on initial load. Dates can be specified using the value property. In the data method, I define a variable, date value, and assign a value to it. I then assign this variable to the value property. As you can see, the specified date value is selected. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. First, I declare a variable, minDate, and set a start date value. Similarly, I define another variable, maxDate, and set it as the end date value. Then, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Check now, I cannot select a date value that is beyond the specified min and max date range. You can select multiple dates in a calendar by adding the isMultiSelection property. In the data method, I add variable isMultiSelection and set its value to true. Assign this variable to the isMultiSelection property. As you can see, I've selected multiple dates. Finally, I will show you how to change and navigate between different views of the calendar. There are three types of views: month, year, and decade. So far, we have been working with the default month view. To change the view to decade, I add the start property and set its value to decade. I'll also remove the maximum range limit. Now the calendar displays each year in a decade. When I click a specific year, it shows the list of months in the year, and on clicking the month again, it shows the days of the selected month. This is the drill down action of calendar view navigation from decade to month view. Using start and depth properties, I can limit the drill down and drill up actions while navigating through the views. Now, I will show you how to control the drill up action using the depth property. I include the depth property and set its value to year. Note that the depth value should always be lesser than the start value. As you can see, when I select a year from the calendar, it shows months in a year, and on clicking a month, it does not show the days of that month. This shows how easily you can define the features of the Vue calendar using its simple built-in APIs. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Vue Calendar component using the Vue CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.